Delphi Economic Forum συζητάμε με τον κύριο David Corani, ο οποίος είναι διευθυντής του Ενεργειακού Κέντρου Eurasia από το Ατλαντικό Συμβούλιο των Ηνωμένων Πολιτειών της Αμερικής. Ο Mr. Corani, we are here in Delphi in the first Economic Forum. I want a first comment of yours for this initiative, which is, in my opinion, unique for the Greek standards.
I think it's critically important, and I'm very, very pleased to be here. I think we convene here in Delphi at a critical time, not just for the region, but also for global political and economic and also energy developments. So I think this gathering and the topics that are on the agenda are very, very important for the regional stability and security, but also the stability and security and the future of the European Union, and indeed great power relations in the 21st century.
There is a very important and critical issue, in my opinion, for Mediterranean and Southeastern European region as well, regarding the relations and the accommodation between US and Russia, if we take into account the Ukrainian crisis and any other issue between these two countries.
We get it here at a very interesting moment, because we are only a couple of days after the nominal implementation of a ceasefire deal between Russia and the United States in Syria. And we will see how this will unfold. We are in the very early days of this ceasefire arrangement. To be honest, I am very, very moderately optimistic only. I could even say that I'm quite skeptical about the feasibility and the staying power of that deal for a number of reasons. One, I am very, very concerned about the outlook from the Assad regime and also in Moscow. My understanding is that they view themselves as being on the offensive. And from a military perspective, on the ground in Syria, they have been on the offensive for the past couple of months. So they managed to retake strategic positions around Aleppo, and they feel themselves reinforced in their ability to regain more ground in the future. So that plays against the sustainability of the ceasefire. I'm also concerned about the outlook of Russia and what Putin is trying to accomplish in Syria. My understanding is, and of course, it's speculation, because we are having difficulties in reading the Russian president's mind in terms of what his strategic objectives are. But in my mind, what he wants to accomplish, essentially three things. One is to prop up the Assad regime and make sure that it doesn't fall, and his main client in the Middle East stays in power for the foreseeable future. Issue number two is that he wants to retain the Syria conflict, because it suits his purpose quite nicely, in as much as it actually provides a conflict where his own extremists from Russia go, and it's easier for him to kill them off on foreign soil as opposed to back home. It also provides him with a conflict where he can play the role of a global power. And he can play that role he always coveted for himself since Soviet times, that Russia is indeed a global power. And finally, I think it's also very convenient for him from the point of view of sustaining that pressure on Europe in the form of the refugee crisis. So if the Syria conflict remains, which is the likely scenario, then this continuous outflow of refugees from Syria, from the wider region, will continue to exert pressure on Europe. And that's, I think, highly relevant from a Greek perspective as well, of course. Mm-hmm.
Talking about the Greek perspective, Greece now is in a very serious threshold because of the economic crisis, 6 years now, the debt crisis, and now in addition with the refugee problem, you know that is totally relative to Syria's crisis. And all this issue about the accommodation between US and Russia and the movements of President Putin, how could affect the effort that is being done by Greece, first of all, to exit the debt crisis, to get out of them MOUs, and if it's possible. And secondly, but not at least, the story about the refugee problem and the refugee crisis.
I mean, Greece, unfortunately, will have to continue to operate in a very tough strategic environment. So again, I'm not very optimistic in terms of the future of the Middle East in the next couple of years, in the short and medium term. So this pressure, both from a political security perspective and from an economic perspective, will likely remain. The key in my mind is multiple pillar strategy in terms of, first of all, reinforce the European Union and to come up with joint European answers to the refugee crisis first and foremost, that will help the economic and the refugee pressure on Greece, and that comes up with a more unified, stronger, more equitable European system, asylum system, and a system for handling the refugees. And unfortunately, we don't see this unfold yet. There are deep divisions within Europe, and this is interpreted also in the context of Brexit, a new East-West divide between some of the newer member states, the Visegrad 4, and their reluctance to take in more refugees, the huge political debate about quotas. My main concern is that this is not just a major challenge from a regional security perspective, but this is a challenge from the point of view of the cohesion of the European Union going forward. And that's also in the strategic interest of the United States, and the United States is extremely worried about the European Union's ability to handle the crisis and its cohesion going forward.
Turkey's role in all this environment?
So it's very, very complicated, because on the one hand, Turkey also faces tremendous pressures because of the refugee population already there. So Turkey has to accommodate somewhere between 2.5 to 3 million refugees as of now, which is, of course, the tremendous economic and also political security pressure on the country itself. So to a large extent, it's understandable, and Turkey is a critical part of any solution to the refugee crisis, and also a critical part of a Syrian solution, if there is any, going forward. Unfortunately, the current political leadership in Turkey is very uncertain in terms of its own strategic rationale and outlook in terms of how to leverage the refugee crisis. I see positive signs in terms of their understanding and their willingness to assist the European Union with the refugee flows. On the other hand, because of that tremendous pressure on Turkey itself, I think there is a very limited extent that the Turkish government and the Turkish leadership will be able to stem the flows in any meaningful way going forward.
Thank you very much, Mr. Koren.
Thank you very much.